Nowadays, a lot of people who don't support actions of the Russian government in Ukraine decided to leave Russia. But now it's even more difficult than it was before. Leaving Russia nowadays can be stressful for many reasons. First, you might have problem at passport control while leaving Russia. I know about many cases when people were questioned by an FSB agent, ex-KGB. They checked their phones looking for any information that could compromise them, their messages, searching for anything against Putin, against the war, and even browser history and recommendations on YouTube. I was prepared for that and cleaned my messages history, but luckily it wasn't necessary because nobody questioned me anything. It was a bit funny that the woman at passport control used a ruler to measure something in my passport, I guess to make sure that it's not fake, and also she used a modifying glass. Another problem about living in Russia nowadays, it's of course money, because ruble has dropped significantly, and of course there is another very practical problem, there are no flights. There are two the most popular ways to go from Russia to Europe nowadays. It's to have connecting flights in Belgrade, Serbia, or in Istanbul, Turkey. Since the demand is much bigger than the offer, the price of all the tickets is extremely high nowadays. But the high price is not the only problem. There is another serious issue, especially considering the flights to and from Belgrade. There have been numerous anonymous threats about bombs on the board. Because of this, the flights were often disrupted. In some cases, the planes were diverted back after taking off. In some cases, they were delayed for many hours, or as it was in my case, the problems occurred when we landed, even if my plane took off on time. Before the flight, I was really stressed because of these bomb threats, and when our flight departed on time and the flight itself went smoothly, I thought I was lucky and could avoid these bomb threat issues, but the problems waited for us after landing. When we landed, we saw that outside the plane there were soldiers in black masks with weapons and dogs. And the crew of the airplane announced that we had to stay inside the plane until the special services check the plane because of a bomb threat. It was really strange for me that they made people stay inside when there was a possible threat of explosion. In my opinion, in this case, you should make people leave the plane as soon as possible. After half an hour, they finally let us leave the plane and started checking us with X-rays. A lot of people had connecting flights in Belgrade, which they missed, because in most cases, Belgrade is not the final point. It's just a place where you take a flight to go to another European country. When all the checks were over, my plane to Milan was still at the airport, but they say that the boarding was over and they didn't let me on the plane. And not only me, but also 10 more people which were flying to the same direction. They made us wait at the airport for 4 or 5 hours before they decided the organization issues. Then they gave us a bus, transferred to a hotel, and next morning they gave us all different flights in exchange of those that they missed on the previous day. I had to admit that besides making us wait for a very long time, in general, Air Serbia worked quite well. They settled us in quite a nice hotel, gave dinner and breakfast, and then brought us to the airport and sent us to our final destinations with other flights. And they didn't ask any additional money for this. In general, I guess that in the end, Air Serbia didn't earn almost anything from this flight, considering all these expenses. So living in Russia nowadays is extremely stressful, but I am glad that I did it and that now I am not in Russia, at least temporarily.